Well, good morning. I'm happy to be here to start off this first half of a two-part talk. We're going to be talking today about telomeres. And does this work? OK, there's a bit of a delay. So we're going to be talking about telomeres. And telomeres are the very ends of chromosomes. Most of what you probably are used to people talking about when they talk about chromosomes is all of the material along the length of the chromosome. And today, we're just going to be depicting that as a black box. Because what we're going to be interested in is the very end of the chromosome, the telomere, which means the end part of the chromosome. And we're going to talk about the critical roles that these telomere play in the health of a cell and also the health of humans. So telomeres are made up of simple, tandemly repeated DNA sequences. So here's that black box. It's the chromosome. And these are the telomeric repeats. And it turns out that the way that DNA is replicated when cells divide, so you have to copy all of the chromosomes in the cell every time a cell divides, that there's a little bit at the end of the chromosome that isn't replicated during that duplication. So as a consequence, as cells go through many rounds of cell division, they lose these telomeric units from the ends of their chromosomes. Now, of course, we wouldn't all be sitting here if this just happened indefinitely. So it turns out that the cell has a very specific mechanism for adding sequences back onto the end of the telomere to be able to maintain the chromosomes. So that mechanism is what we call the telomerase enzyme. And so when you have shortened telomeric repeats, this little machine in the cell that we call telomerase will add repeats back onto the end of the chromosome. So the chromosome isn't maintained at a unique length, but rather there's continual shortening and lengthening and shortening and lengthening to maintain telomere length. So as a consequence, within the cell, all of the different chromosomes have a slightly different telomere length. There's this equilibrium that is maintained of shortening and lengthening. And so this leads to equilibrium distribution that telomeres are maintained around. And we'll be talking about this distribution. So this is telomere length and the number of ends that have a particular length. This distribution is very important to maintain because if the telomeres are too short, there's disease. And if the telomeres are too long, there's disease. So we were interested a number of years ago in trying to understand what would happen if you didn't have telomerase and you couldn't maintain those telomeric repeats. So we generated a telomerase null mouse, shown here. And this is the first generation telomerase null mouse. And those mice were perfectly fine. There was nothing wrong with them. So we took two of the first generation and bred them together to give the second generation, or G2 telomerase null mice, and then took those G2s and bred them to each other to generate the third generation, bred those together, generate the fourth generation, fifth generation, sixth generation. And what we learned from those mice is that it's only when the telomeres get to be very short that there's any consequence. The earliest generations of that breeding had no effects at all. So the consequence is that when you have very short telomeres, there's a threshold. And when you go below that threshold, there is stem cell failure and a number of other diseases associated with cellular senescence. So there's a short telomere threshold here. It turns out in work that we and others have done over the years, there's also an important role that telomeres play in limiting the division of cancer cells. So telomeres can limit the division of normal cells, leading to stem cell failure, or of cancer cells. And so if telomeres are too long, then there's a predisposition to cancer. And this tells you why, then, it's so important to maintain that equilibrium. And that's what we're very interested in, is the fundamentals of this equilibrium. So telomeres are basically a buffer zone, right? So there's a ruler here for this telomere. And you can have 10 units long, or 8, or 7, or 6. And there's no consequence until the telomere gets to be very short. So this is all basically a buffer zone. But when the telomere gets to be very short, it leads to age-related degenerative diseases. Now, we showed over 20 years ago that in humans, telomeres actually shorten progressively over the lifetime. So this shows telomere white blood cells with the average telomere length and the age of the donor. And there was a progressive decline in telomere length. You'll be hearing more about this from Mary Armanios. But I just want to show one slide that points out that there is a normal distribution in the population of telomere length. So this is over 200 normal individuals measuring their telomere length. And there's a wide distribution of what is normal in the population. There's been a lot in the popular press about telomere length and aging. And I just wanted to make one point here, that if I gave you a sample of DNA, and you measured the telomere length of that DNA, and it was had 8 kilobases of telomeric repeat, that individual could be 7 years old, or that individual could be 75 years old. So it's not determinative. The telomere length is not determinative. There's a wide range of normal in the population. However, that being said, outside of these norms, there are very specific disease states, which you'll be hearing about from Mary Armanios in the next talk. So what we're interested in is this equilibrium and not being able to fall too far too short for age-related degenerative disease or too long for cancer. And so my laboratory is focused on how you maintain this equilibrium at this very unique set point. So the areas that we're very interested in have to do with, this is the other version of telomerase besides the little cartoon Pac-Man that I showed earlier. So this is a little telomerase cartoon. In order for telomerase to be able to maintain the telomeres, it has to interact with the components, the molecular components that are right at the telomere. And so what's shown here, the names aren't important, but there's a collection of proteins that are bound to the end of the chromosome. And telomerase has to interact with those in order to be able to lengthen the telomere. And so there are really two fundamental things that can be regulated. You can regulate how frequently telomerase will get on to the end of the chromosome, or you can regulate when it gets on, how much it makes. So these are the two fundamental components, and we're very interested in understanding the molecular details of how telomerase knows both how frequently to get on and how much to make. So having said that telomeres are very important in disease, I also want to just point out that it's a little bit nuanced, because there's a lot of hyperbole out there as well. If you can go to various websites and find out all kinds of things that they say about telomeres and aging. So this one suggests that your telomeres will get longer, and then you will live longer. And you can't really see this over here, but there are various sponsored ads for this. So there's a lot of hype that's out there, and some of those sponsored ads are for nutraceuticals. So here's Telomere Plus, Telomere Cream for your face, Telomere Support, another anti-aging, I like this one a lot, Telomax does more than just help maintain long telomeres. Telomeres Up, more Telomere Face Cream, Telovite, Telomere Anti-Aging Formula, Telomere Advantage, and my favorite, Telomere Benefits, or maybe Telomeres with Benefits, I'm not sure. Buyer beware, though it is true that telomeres play a major role in disease, there's also a lot of things out there. I have no evidence that any of these things actually change telomere length. Just to caution you. But back to what we're really interested, the fundamentals. Despite the hype that's out there, it's fairly nuanced. There is hype that is not to be believed, but there is also a very important role that telomeres do play in disease. And so what we're interested in is how is this balance maintained? How does the telomere length normally get maintained? So by understanding how it works, we'll be able to have new approaches to treat disease.